The following has been rated PC for politically correct.
Pay attention, you just may learn something.
It's the Sage, Larry Elder.
Now we're talking about the New Deal. And you're taught in high school that FDR jumped on a white horse, a winged white horse, and passed all these wonderful policies like the National Recovery Act that rescued the country from the Great Depression. And again, Lee Ohanian from UCLA says it's nonsense that what FDR did was to make things worse. Had he done nothing, the economy would have snapped back. What he did prolonged and deepened the recession and turned it into a Great Depression. We know this by just analyzing the words of FDR's own former Secretary of Treasury. And he wrote in his diary that what we've done has made things worse. Here's what he said. His name is Henry Morgenthau, FDR's Treasury Secretary. Quote, "We have tried spending money. We are spending more than we have ever spent before, and it does not work. I want to see this country prosperous. I want to see people get a job. I want to see people get enough to eat. We have never made good on our promises. I say, after 8 years of this administration, we have just as much unemployment as when we started, and an enormous debt to boot." End of quote. This is what Henry Morgenthau, FDR's Treasury Secretary, wrote in his diary. And yet we hear about how FDR rescued the economy from the Great Depression. His own Secretary of Treasury said, after spending and spending and spending for 8 years, we have enormous debt and we have not turned the situation around. There's a piece written by Jim Powell, who's a researcher with the Cato Institute, this libertarian think tank in Washington, D.C. The headline is, "Why Did FDR's New Deal Harm Blacks?" We're going to put this up on LarryElder.com. The flagship of the New Deal was something called the National Industrial Recovery Act, passed in June of 1933. It gave the president the power to issue executive orders that established 700 industrial cartels, restricted output, forced wages and prices above market level. Minimum wage regulations made it illegal for employers to hire people who were willing to work below the minimum wage level. Powell writes, and I'm quoting, "As a result, some 500,000 blacks, particularly in the South, were estimated to have lost jobs." End of quote. He says FDR tripled federal taxes from 1933 to 1940. Social Security excise taxes on payrolls discouraged employers from hiring. New Deal securities laws made it harder for employers to raise capital. New Deal antitrust lawsuits harassed some 150 employers and entire industries. Quote, "Whatever the merits of such policies might have been, it was bizarre to disrupt private sector employment when the median unemployment rate was 17%. End of quote. He talks about the Agricultural Adjustment Act, 1933, aimed to help farmers by cutting back production and forcing up food prices. Quote, "Less production meant less work for thousands of poor black sharecroppers. In addition, blacks were among the 100 million consumers forced to pay higher food prices because of the Agricultural Adjustment Act of 1933. He talks about the Wagner Act of 1935. Which, quote, harmed blacks by making labor union monopolies legal. The Wagner Act raised the number of insiders, those with jobs, who had an incentive and an ability to exclude those without jobs. Quote, once high wages have been negotiated, employers are less likely to hire outsiders, and thus the insiders could protect their own interest," close quote. Also, he writes this about the Wagner Act, quote, "By giving labor unions the monopoly power to exclusively represent employees in a workplace, the Wagner Act had the effect of excluding blacks, since the dominant unions discriminated against blacks." And it said that the act initially had been drafted with a provision that prohibited racial discrimination, but the American Federation of Labor successfully lobbied against it, and that provision that prohibited racial discrimination was dropped. And so you had people like Booker T. Washington, W.E.B. Du Bois, and Marcus Garvey, all critical of this Wagner Act and its compulsory unionism. He talks about the Tennessee Valley Authority, which was set up to provide electricity in the South. Quote, among other things, the TVA flooded an estimated 730,000 acres of land behind its dams, and 15,654 people were forced out of their homes. Farm owners received cash settlements for their condemned property, but tenant farmers, a large number of whom were black, got nothing. Historians have chronicled the TVA social experiment, he writes, as a failure. And even the spending programs, he said, didn't work because the poorest people, including millions of blacks, didn't get the money. They were already going to vote for FDR. So he spent more money on western states and eastern states whose election returns had been relatively close because FDR was focused on winning the next election. Quote, if FDR's New Deal policies were not racist in their intent, they certainly had racist consequences. End of quote.